بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم மதிப்புக்குரிய ப்ராஜெக்ட் டைரக்டர் அவர்களே, மதிப்புக்குரிய பிரின்சிபல் அவர்களே, மதிப்புக்குரிய சகோதர சகோதரிகளே, உங்களை எல்லாருக்கும் என்னுடைய வணக்கத்தை சலாம் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். திருவள்ளுவர் சொன்னார், கற்க கசடர கற்பவை கற்ற பின் நிற்க அதற்குத்தக. இந்த குறளுடைய அர்த்தம் உங்களுக்கு நான் சொல்லக்கூடியது அவசியம் இல்லைன்னு நினைக்கிறேன். This is the purpose of education. Unfortunately, we seem to have forgotten that. And we think that education is simply to fill the minds of students with bits and pieces of data, which we like to call knowledge. Data is not knowledge. Data is not even information. Data is data. Data which is understood is information. Information that can be leveraged and used for something is knowledge. The meaning and the effect of that knowledge is wisdom. Now we just have data and we call it knowledge, it's not knowledge. I want to show you two videos and then I'm going to ask you a few questions. My idea today is not to give you any lecture here, we will just share some thoughts. And inshallah, if you then allow me to leave here in one piece, then tomorrow I will come again to talk to you again tomorrow inshallah. To the students. You are also near So inshallah to you and to them we will talk tomorrow. So first I am going to request Lakshmi Sri to please play the two videos. Just watch these two videos, then we will talk about. Thank you.
In 1999, to try and address this problem with an experiment, which was a very simple experiment in New Delhi, I basically embedded a computer into a wall of a slum in New Delhi. The children barely went to school, they didn't know any English, they'd never seen a computer before, and they didn't know what the internet was. I connected high-speed internet to it, it's about 3 feet off the ground, turned it on and left it there. After this, we noticed a couple of interesting things which you see, but I repeated this all over India and then through a large part of the world, and noticed that children will learn to do what they want to learn to do. This is the first experiment that we did. 8-year-old boy on your right, teaching his student, a 6-year-old girl, and he was teaching her how to browse. This boy here in the middle of central India, this is in the Rajasthan village where the children recorded their own music and then played it back to each other, and in the process they enjoyed themselves thoroughly. They did all of this in 4 hours after seeing the computer for the first time. In another South Indian village, these boys here had assembled a video camera and were trying to take photograph of a bumblebee. They downloaded it from Disney.com or one of these websites 14 days after putting the computer in their village. So at the end of it, we concluded that groups of children can learn to use computers and the internet on their own, irrespective of who or where they were. At that point, I became a little more ambitious and decided to see what else could children do with a computer. We started off with an experiment in Hyderabad, India, where I gave a group of children, they spoke English with a very strong Telugu accent. I gave them a computer with a speech-to-text interface, which you now get free with Windows, and asked them to speak into it. So when they spoke into it, the computer typed out gibberish. So they said, well, it doesn't understand anything of what we're saying. So I said, yeah, I'll leave it here for 2 months. Make yourself understood to the computer. So the children said, how do we do that? And I said, well, I don't know, actually. And I left. Two months later, and this is now documented in the Information Technology for International Development Journal, their accents had changed and were remarkably close to the neutral British accent in which I had trained the speech-to-text synthesizer. In other words, they were all speaking like James Toody. So you can, they could do that on their own. After that, I started to experiment with various other things that they might learn to do on their own. I got an interesting phone call once from Colombo, from the late Arthur C. Clarke, who said, I want to see what's going on. And he couldn't travel, so I went over there. He said two interesting things. A teacher that can be replaced by a machine should be. The second thing he said was that if children have interest, then education happens. And I was doing that in the field, so every time I would watch it and think of it.
Possible. And they can definitely help people, because children very quickly learn to navigate the web and find things which interest them. And when you've got interest, then you have education.
I took the experiment to South Africa. This is a 15-year-old boy.
This machine, I play games like animals, and I listen to music.
And I asked him, do you send emails? And he said yes, and they hop across the ocean. This is in Cambodia, rural Cambodia. A very silly arithmetic game, which no child would play inside the classroom or at home. They would, you know, throw it back at you. They'd say, this is very boring. If you leave it on the pavement, and if all the adults go away, then they will show off with each other about what they can do, which is what these children are doing. So they're trying to multiply, I think. And all over India, at the end of about 2 years, children were beginning to Google their homework. As a result, the teachers reported tremendous improvements in their English. You know, rapid improvements and all sorts of things. They said they've become really deep thinkers and so on and so forth. And indeed they had. I mean, if there's stuff on Google, why would you need to stuff it into your head? So at the end of the next 4 years, I decided that groups of children can navigate the internet to achieve educational objectives on their own. At that time, a large amount of money had come into Newcastle University to improve schooling in India. So Newcastle gave me a call. I said, I'll do it from Delhi. They said, there's no way you're going to handle £1 million worth of university money sitting in Delhi. So in 2006, I bought myself a heavy overcoat and moved to Newcastle. I wanted to test the limits of this system. The first experiment I did out of Newcastle was actually done in India, and I set myself an impossible target. Can Tamil-speaking 12-year-old children in a South Indian village teach themselves biotechnology in English on their own? And I thought, I'll test them, they'll get a zero, I'll give them material, I'll come back and test them, they'll get another zero, I'll go back and say, yes, we need teachers for certain things. I called in 26 children, they all came in there, told them that there's some really difficult stuff on this computer. I wouldn't be surprised if you didn't understand anything. It's all in English, and I'm going. So I left them with it. I came back after 2 months and the 26 children marched in looking very, very quiet. I said, well, did you look at any of the stuff? Said, yes, we did. Did you understand anything? No, nothing. So I said, well, how long did you practice on it before you decided that you understood nothing? He said, we look at it every day. So I said, for 2 months you were looking at stuff you didn't understand. So a 12-year-old girl raises her hand and says, literally, apart from the fact that improper replication of the DNA molecule causes genetic disease, we've understood nothing else. Took me 3 years to publish that. It's just been published in the British Journal of Educational Technology. One of the referees who refereed the paper said, it's too good to be true. Which was not very nice. Well, one of the girls had taught herself to become the teacher. And that's her over there.
I want you to, the point I want you to think about here is,
what is this, before we go to that, what is the, what is it? Come here, Yegra.
What is the message that you understood from this, this is a very serious teaching experiment being done. This is not some Bollywood movie, right? What do you understand from this? Details? There's no need for a teacher. That's it. Teachers are not needed. Because what he is dealing with is, in one case, slum children who have never seen a computer in their lives, 8-year-old and 6-year-old. And how long does it take them to start using it and browsing? 6 hours. 6 hours. Now my point, if I came here without this documented evidence, if I told you that children who never saw a computer in their life, they don't know English, slum children can learn how to operate a computer in 6 hours, you will, maybe you will not say anything because I'm an old man, but otherwise you will think this man is கேப்பீங்க என்ன சார் இந்த ஒரு 4 மணி நேரத்துல நீங்க சாராயம் கொடுத்து வந்து பேசுறீங்களா அப்படின்னு கேப்பீங்க இல்லையா. But that is a fact. The last one he is talking about is Tamil speaking, 12-year-old Tamil speaking girls who have no knowledge of English are studying biotechnology on their own in 2 months. So what is the message? Teachers are not required. Language is not a barrier. Where you live is not a barrier. Whether you are rich or poor is not a barrier. Your caste is not a barrier. Your religion is not a barrier. Nothing is a barrier. The only thing required is interest, willingness to learn. Right? All right. Now see the next movie. Come on. This one, video is here. You can watch this one. It's a 20 minute. I don't want to keep you for. You already at 4:30. So I. My point is made, the video is there with madam, you can see the whole video please. And then you will have the whole list of his experiments, please see all that, no problem. But this one I wanted to see. Huh?
here. And so there's nothing important about this. Let me sit here, I need to see you and I need to see the screen also. What did you see here just now? Entrepreneurship. You saw entrepreneurship, not what we like to see, but that is entrepreneurship. I guarantee you, supposing I, before I show, now you have also learned a method, please don't use it, but that's the method. Before this, if I told you, if I gave you a bottle of, empty bottle, and I told you, you have to fill water, then you have to seal it in such a way that somebody else will think this has come from the factory. Without using any tools. So my point is, what is this child lacking? Does he lack intelligence?
Knowledge.
So this child, if you teach him maths and science, he will not do this job? இவன் அவன் பண்ற வேலை சரியா இல்லையா? திட்டு தானே, திருட்டு வேலை தான் இல்லையா? இட் இஸ் ராங், நோ, இல்லீகல். சோ பை டீச்சிங் ஹிம் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் மேத்ஸ் இஸ் ஹி கோயிங் டு ஸ்டாப் டூயிங் தட் ஒர்க்? வாட் இஸ் ஹி லேக்கிங்? மாரல் வேல்யூஸ். மாரல் வேல்யூ இஸ் நாட் லேக்கிங் இன் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் மேத்ஸ், இஸ் நாட் லேக்கிங் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் லாங்குவேஜ். அது அவனுக்கு, அவருக்கு இங்கிலீஷ் படிச்சு கொடுத்தா முடிஞ்சு பாப்பா. எத்தனை பாட்டில் தூக்கிட்டு போவாங்க? How many were there? Did you count? Anybody? 10 bottles. 8 from one side, he brought 2 from the other side. 1 liter, assuming it is 1 liter, that looks like 1 and a half liters to me. But 1 and a half liters. 1 and a half liters. போடுங்க, உங்க மேக்ஸ். 15 kilograms. That child is carrying 15 kilograms of water on his back like that and he is running. Here is a young man, citizen of this country, who has got the energy, who has got the strength, who has got the intelligence. And what is he doing? He's stealing. He's a thief. Then we have school after school after school. What is the point of the school? Tell me. அதனால நான் சொன்னேன், எனக்கு இங்க இருந்து நீங்க போறதுக்கு அனுமதி கொடுத்தீங்கன்னா நாளைக்கு வருவேன். இங்க கொல்லிட்டு போட்டா அவ்வளவுதான். ஏன் இங்க வந்துட்டு நமக்கு இப்படி சொல்றாரு, டீச்சர்ஸ்க்கு அவசியம், டீச்சர்ஸ் அவசியமே இல்லைன்னு சொல்றாரு, அதுக்கப்புறம் ஸ்கூல்ஸ் அவசியம் இல்லைன்னு சொல்றாரு. என்னது கூப்பிட்டீங்க? அவங்களுக்கு கேட்பாங்க, அவங்க ஏன் கூப்பிட்டாங்க இவருக்கு? இந்த மாதிரி ஆளுக்கெல்லாம் கூப்பிடக்கூடாது. ஆனா இப்ப வந்தாச்சு, என்ன பண்ணுது? Seriously, I want you to think about this. I'm not saying teachers are not required. Teachers are, you know why teachers are required? For this. Not for science and technology. Really, seriously, I'm telling you. Science and technology, teachers are not required. Today, technology is getting more and more and more such that anybody with an interest can learn. Practically everything on MIT is available. I've given madam several videos. Please watch all of that. There's a video called For the Love of Physics. Right, please sit and watch those videos. Really eye-opening. How teachers who love the subject, how they teach. Now, all of that material is open source material. You can sit here in Kilakarai and you can access material from Harvard, from MIT, from Sloan, from various places, completely free of cost. So, you don't need to spend money, you don't need to travel anywhere, you can sit in your house. And if you are interested in learning, you can learn anything at all. You will not get a degree from MIT, but who cares? You've got the knowledge, you can do the work. Whether you actually have a piece of paper or not, it doesn't matter. So why do we need teachers? We need teachers to teach moral values. We need teachers to make ethical, moral human beings. Today, the root cause of our problems, whether it is this country or some other country or the whole world, is not because people don't know English, it is not because people don't know maths, it is not because people don't know science, it is not because people don't know history and geography. All of those things are important. I'm not trashing them. I'm not saying they're not important. They're all is important. But the problems are because people do not know moral values. People do not have ethics. People do not believe and understand that oppressing somebody is wrong. People do not have any concern for committing crimes. When a crime is being committed, what are people nowadays doing? They are taking a video and putting it on social media. What should they do if a crime is being committed? It's like you saw in the video here, that boy is filling those bottles, that man comes and stands there, he watches him and he goes and he doesn't even stop the boy. He doesn't tell him, what are you doing? This is wrong. He does not say it. That is why we need teachers. Right? Any question? What is it? So let me ask you this question. Why do you have this school? What is your purpose? Anybody? So look, why do you have this school? People at the back. It's your destiny. To teach time management, you have the school. Okay. Anybody else? To give an atmosphere in which child can develop. Okay. Anybody? Good, very good. Then anybody else? That's it. Why do you have school? It's not an exam. There's no marks, no pass, no fail. Tell me. You get moral values for the children? Discipline and moral values. You have a parent-teacher association here? So who's the school for? Students. But you have got a parent teacher association. Na enna solren purinjada? I was the correspondent of a school, the Arunachalam Higher Secondary School in Thiruvattar. Kulashekara pakkathula. I used to come to Madurai very often at that time because of the labor court is here. So for any labor cases for the rubber estates, I used to come here. 1200 students, 75 teachers. The school was a partially aided school and it was doing so badly that we were losing teachers because if there wasn't enough students, then the government would not do the funding. So when I took over the school as the correspondent, I called a meeting of teachers, they all came. It so happened, coincidentally, that this was immediately after the term exam. And the English, it was a Tamil school, but there was one English was one subject. So the English language class, the entire class failed. Whole class. The English teacher, I won't tell you his name and all that because this is being videoed. I don't want people to feel, you know, bad about it. But so I asked him, I said, how did you manage to do this? How did you achieve this? No, it's an achievement. No? I mean, how can the whole class fail? That is an achievement, isn't it? Few people fail means one can understand, but whole class fails means achievement. So I said, how did you get this achievement? How do you do it? He's telling me, sir, இவங்க எல்லாம் low caste sir, Dalit, அவங்களுக்கு அவ்வளவுதான் புத்தி இருக்கு சார், என்ன பண்றதுன்னு சொல்றேன். அப்ப நான் வந்து இந்த மாதிரி சேருக்கு எல்லாம் பிடிச்சி அப்படி உட்கார்ந்தேன். பிகாஸ் கை விட்டா போய் அடிச்சிருப்பேன் அவனே. அப்ப அடுத்த நாள் ஒரு போலீஸ் கேஸ் கீஸ் அதை வேண்டாம் இப்ப வந்து பிடிச்சி. My point is, if that is the attitude of the teacher, how will he teach? Tell me. ஆரம்பத்திலே அவன் வந்து இது தீர்மானம் பண்ணிட்டான் ஃபார் ஹிம்செல்ஃப், இவங்களுக்கு புத்தி இல்லை. So that school, what I did was, I set up a student council. That's why I put up this slide. Ask them, I say, who's the school for? Same answer. This is no for the children, discipline, as easy time management, namak namak everything. So I said then, in the decision making for the school, are the children involved? So they looked at me like I am crazy or something. But you know, I am correspondent, what can they tell me? So they did not say anything. So I said, if the school is for the children, how is it that children are not involved in decision making? I said, who decides what time the school starts? So we decide management, okay. I said, who decides how long a particular period should be? We decide. I said, who decides the timetable? We decide. Who decides the duration of lunch break, tea break, whatever break? We decide. Right? So I said, everything you decide, but school is for somebody else. So I said, what do you call a place where the inmates have no decision making powers? What is it called? Prison. No? Prisoners have no authority. They cannot eat when they want to eat. They have to eat when they are told to eat. They cannot sleep when they want to sleep. They have to sleep when they are told to sleep. And they cannot come anywhere, go anywhere. Gate is closed. You cannot go back. Once you are inside only when the gate is open. Then you can go outside. அப்படிதானே நீங்க யாரும் ஜெயிலுக்கு போறது இல்ல தெரியும் எனக்கு போயிருக்க மாட்டீங்க போ வேண்டாம் வித்தியாசம் என்னன்னு கேட்டேன் இது ஜெயில் ஒரு ஸ்கூல் என்ன வித்தியாசம் என்ன ஒன்லி டிஃபரன்ஸ் இஸ் ஜெயில் தட் ஃபெலோ இஸ் நாட் பேயிங் ஹியர் இஸ் பேயிங் டு பி இம்ப்ரிசன்ட் So, I said, okay, I'm going to change this. One more thing, that school had an area of 2 acres. Yeah? How many schools have got 2 acres of land? Nice, big 2 acres of land. But that was like a 2 acre garbage dump. எங்கே பார்த்தாலும் என்னமோ அந்த பேப்பர் அது இது வாழைப்பழம் all kinds of things everywhere. The walls of the school, they have scrambled, written all sorts of stuff on the walls. Those children were, they were from class 5 to class 12. They were very, very fast on their feet. Why? Because the principal, the teachers operated on one rule. That rule is, பையன் கை கடிச்ச உடனே அடிக்கணும். Why are you beating him? Because he may have done something at some time. At that time, I could not catch him. Now I caught him. Or maybe he will do something in the future. No. So I said, first of all, I said, no teacher will touch a student no matter what. I said, if you touch the student, I will touch you. Simple as that. You go call the police, I don't care. So, first thing. I said, second thing is, we will form a student council. They said, what is that? I said, student council is a council in which there will be students and teachers also will be there, representatives of teachers and students. They said, what will the council decide? I said, everything. I said, what do you mean everything? I said, council will decide whether, what time school will begin, what time school will end, duration of every period, which period, what subject they want to study, what they don't want to study. Today should be a holiday. Why? Just because I feel like a holiday. Yes, you can have a holiday. No problem. Right? They will decide everything that needs to be decided because the school is for them. They said, idhi mudiyadhu. I said, ella mudiyum. Because mudiyadhan sonnaka, I said, I am the correspondent, I am paying your salary, that is the door. Up to you. So, very unhappy, I had to force it, there was no other way of doing it. So, they agreed. So, we had some teacher representative, we got the students. Now, when the students came, what do? You think they were very happy? No, they were equally unhappy. They thought, this is some drama, this is some game, I am trying to trap them or something. Because they never had, the teachers never heard of this, the student never heard of this. So I had to do a whole class for the student, counseling for them. I said, look, this is, I am serious. They said, நாளைக்கு வந்து லீவ் கொடுக்க சொன்னா கொடுப்பீங்களா அப்படியா சரி இனி 10 நாள் I said 10 நாள் வேணா 10 நாள் கொடுப்பேன் ஒரு மாசம் வேணா ஒரு மாசம் கொடுப்பேன் ஆனால் உங்க சிலபஸ் இருக்கல அது முடிக்கணும் Because school is for some purpose, no? So, there is a portion to be completed, right? எனக்கு இன்னைக்கு வந்து எனக்கு படிக்கிறதுக்கு இஷ்டமே இல்லை எனக்கு ரொம்ப போர் அடிக்குது நான் வெளியே போய் விளையாடுறேன்னா ஓ நோ ப்ராப்ளம் கோ ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் யூ டு சிட் ஹியர் வித் யுவர் பிரெயின் டெட் எனிவே யூ வாண்ட் டு கோ பிளே But today's work has to be done. இன்னைக்கு பண்ணலனா நாளைக்கு டபுள் பீரியட் எடுக்க முடியும். There is no other way. We'll have to do that. அப்போ அவன் வந்து காதும் கண்ணு எல்லாம் திறந்தது. So I said, now you decide. What period, what do you think we changed? Nothing. So what actually changed? Now they came willingly. Their mindset changed. They realized that this is not some stupid rule. This rule has to be done because we are here to study. Then I told them, I took them all outside. I said, "Idella pari epdi irukku." So they all looking. I said, "Bhai, இது இந்த காகிதம் எல்லாம் இருக்குல்ல, இது எங்க இருந்து வந்தது?" So they didn't say anything. I said, "Enna pannalam?" So I said, "I'll tell you what to do." I said, "I'm not telling you to go clean all this. Don't do it. What I will do is, I said, this whole 2-acre area, I made a map. I said, this map, I am dividing it up between all the classes. So in idu oru plot vandu, in the classes, 5th class this plot, 6th class this plot, 7th class, 8th class, all this. I said, every 3 months I will have a competition and I will give a prize for the best plot. Second prize, third prize. Now imagine, this is Kanyakumari district, border of previous Kerala. That land is so fertile, you put your walking stick, it will sprout. Right? These are children from agricultural families. Literally overnight, that whole place became a garden. Literally overnight. பசங்க வீட்டுல கொண்டு வந்தாங்க என்னென்ன வாட் எவர் பிளான்ஸ் தே வாண்டட் திஸ் சும்மா வந்து சார் இங்க போடலாமா ஐசே உங்க பிளாட் தான் எனக்கே கேட்கறேன் தென் ஐ தே தென் தே கேம் டு மீ தே செட் நீங்க அனுமதி கொடுத்தீங்கன்னா கொஞ்சம் சுண்ணா பெயிண்ட் வேணும் அதுவும் நமக்கு சண்டேக்கு வந்து ஸ்கூலுக்கு வர்றதுக்கு அனுமதி கொடுத்தீங்கன்னா இதெல்லாம் அசிங்கமா இருக்குது அவங்க பண்ணது வேலை தானே அசிங்கமா இருக்குது. நீங்க அனுமதி கொடுத்தீங்கன்னா நம்ம வந்து எல்லாம் பூரா பெயிண்ட் பண்ணி கொடுத்துருவோம். தட்ஸ் இட். டு இட் ஐ வில் ப்ரொவைட் யூ த மெட்டீரியல், நோ ப்ராப்ளம். டு இட். ஹோல் ஸ்கூல் ஷைனிங். எவ்ரிபடி வெரி சர்ப்ரைஸ். ஹவ் இஸ் இட் பாசிபிள்? ஐ சார், வை இஸ் இட் நாட் பாசிபிள்? தட்ஸ் வை ஐ ஆஸ்க் யூ திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன். ஹூ இஸ் த ஸ்கூல் ஃபார்? வாட் இஸ் தி இன்வால்வ்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் த ஸ்டூடெண்ட்? யூ நோ வா decision-making power. We give them no responsibility. We do not teach them how to take decisions. We spoon-feed them, and we spoon-feed them in the name of discipline, in the name of this and that. And then they go out on the street, and then we have a whole population of people who have no sense, no discipline, no responsibility. You will have people driving a Mercedes car. அதுக்கப்புறம் வந்து அவன் லேஸ் சிப்ஸ் சாப்பிட்டு அந்த மாதிரி ஹி வில் த்ரோ தி திங் அவுட் ஆஃப் தி ஹவ் மெனி டைம்ஸ் யூ ஹவ் சீன் இட் ஐ ஹவ் சீன் இட் இல்லையா ஹி இஸ் டிரைவிங் அ கார் வர்த் 50 லேக்ஸ் ஹி வில் த்ரோ தட் பேக்கெட் அவுட் சைட் த கார் கார்பேஜ் அவுட் சைட் ஆன் த ஸ்ட்ரீட் பிகாஸ் சென்ஸ் இஸ் நாட் தேர் நெவர் லேர்ன்ட் தே வுட் ஹவ் கான் டு சம் ஃபேன்சி ஸ்கூல் பர் மந்த் 1 lakh சேலரி கொடுத்துருப்பான் ஆனால் அந்த இடத்த கூட நோ சென்ஸ் ஆஃப் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி நோ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஆஃப் ஹூ யூ ஆர் ஹூ ஐ ஆம் வை ஐ ஆம் திஸ் இஸ் மை பிளேஸ் Who must keep it clean? In Japan, standard practice, I sometimes tell my friend, I said, if you introduce that, if you tell the teachers in our country, maybe you will have a revolution. But in Japan, standard practice, last half hour of every day, the teacher and students themselves, they clean the whole classroom. They clean the classroom, they clean the board, everything, keep it ready for the next day. No, there is no sweeper or somebody to the teacher and the students together. When they lost the World Cup football finals, you know what they did? They cleaned the whole stadium. They lost the match, they could have gone home. No. They walked around with bags, complete garbage la eduthu poora clean panni thulpana. Sense of responsibility. This is why you need teachers. We do not need teachers to do the other stuff. Okay, so our problem today is that we have converted teaching, that's why Mark Twain, a very nice quote, Mark Twain said, I have never allowed schooling to come in the way of my education. In schooling, this is what we do. Discrete subjects, no relation to each other. For example, let me ask you this question. You are teaching history, geography, biology, physics, chemistry, no? Yes or no? No, because in Hyderabad, they do this. You get very confused. Yes or no? Okay. So now, let me ask you a question. You are teaching history, you are teaching botany. Now, in history, say for example, you are teaching something about the British Empire. How the British Empire spread all over the world and how they spent about 200 years stealing from everybody and enriching themselves. They took this country from having a share of world GDP of 24% to 3%. Next subject is botany. Is there any relation between these two subjects? Okay, so metabolism, that way you are in a way allegorically. But do you know the one very major connection between botany and history? Specific to British Empire, especially British, Spanish, Portuguese. How did these empires spread? What was the main reason why they spread all over the world? Because of ships, sailing ships. Yes? The Arabs had sailing ships long centuries before them. The Polynesians had sailing ships centuries before the Arabs. But they never had global empire. You know why? Because the sailing ships of the Arabs and the sailing ships of the Polynesians and others, including Romans, for example. The Romans had sailing ships 2000 years from today. So 2000 years ago. Because their sailing ships could not cross big oceans. Their sailing ships were mostly or entirely restricted to coastal waters. Then how come the British did it? They did it because of the oak tree. They had oak trees, which were very good for making tall masts. So when they made ships, they built big ships with tall masts. Multiple masts. Go and look up a clipper ship. One of the most beautiful things in the world. How they constructed those things. How they used to sail those things. Absolutely incredible the way. On YouTube, look up clipper ships. And because of ship construction, which is related directly to the botany of it, which is the trees, they were able to conquer the world. But of course, they went to school like ours, so they never learnt moral values and ethics and so on and so forth. So, they had those of bandits. That's a different issue. But the point I'm saying is that the relationship of the history class to the botany class. Now, we don't do that. I'm not blaming you. Nobody does it. This is the problem of so-called education. And that is why children, what do children do? Graduation, they finish school, they go home. What do they do with the textbooks? You were all in school sometime, no? I was also in school. What did you and I do with our textbooks the day after we finished schooling? You sell them, right? Do you know anybody who reads the textbook? Never. If you read the textbook, the parents will ask, you know, this fellow's gone mad or what? Why did he read textbook? You will sell it, no? Old books, second-hand books, you will sell them and go and buy some batana or something. Why? Think about this. Here is a child who spends 15 to 17 years studying these things, and the first chance they get, they want to get rid of it. What does it tell us? I was speaking to a group of engineering college students in Assam, big engineering college there. And I asked a question. I said, Hyderabad was with me, I think. So, I asked the question, I said, can anyone tell me what is Archimedes' principle? So, nobody could tell me. Because this is something they would have learnt in literally secondary school maximum, maybe even primary. So, I'm asking them in engineering college. So, one girl, she finally raised her hand, she said, Archimedes' principle. She talked about displacement of fluids. So, I said, fantastic. Then I said, why is Archimedes' principle important? What is the use of learning it? So I'm asking a question, what is Archimedes' principle? You are able to answer, you are not able to answer. So what? Because you don't know, have you lost something? If you say, I never learnt Archimedes' principle, so what? Pythagoras' theorem, I never learnt, so what? But if a question comes in your exam about Pythagoras' theorem and the child writes, so what? Will you pass him or fail him? You understand how meaningless we have made education? Seriously, I'm asking this question. Third question. Exams. What is an exam? Random recall within a specific time frame. Yes or no? So, examination is from 9 to 10:30. 1.5 hours. I'm sure many of you have had this experience yourself or one of your own children or somebody. எக்ஸாம் முடிஞ்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் எப்படி பண்ணுவேன், நல்லா பண்ணேன், நல்லா பண்ணேன், ஆனால் அம்மா ஒரு க்வெஸ்சன் இருந்தது அந்த நேரத்தில் வரவே இல்லை. அப்போ என்னடா பண்ணேன், நான் ஒன்றும் பண்ணலை, ஆனால் வெளியே வந்த உடனே எனக்கு ஆன்சர் ஆச்சு, எனக்கு தெரியும் ஆன்சர். அப்போ என்ன ஆச்சு, இல்லை எக்ஸாம் டைம் முடிஞ்சு போச்சு. அப்போ அந்த பையன் பாஸா ஃபெயிலா? பாஸ் பண்ணணுமே, பண்ண முடிய, ஆனால் நீங்க பண்ண மாட்டீங்களே, பேப்பர் போச்சு. அப்ப அந்த பையனுக்கு அந்த விஷயம் தெரியுமா தெரியாதா? தெரியும் இல்ல. ஆனா பட் பிகாஸ் ஹி இஸ் அனேபிள் டு ரீகால் இட் ஃப்ரம் 9 to 10:30, யூ ஆர் ஃபெயிலிங் ஹிம். நவ பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபெயிலிங் ஹிம் யூ ஆர் ரூயினிங் ஹிஸ் ரெஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் லைஃப். பிகாஸ் சப்போசிங் திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் கம்ஸ் இன் அ ஃபைன் உண்மை யோசி பார்க்க, ஹவு இன்சேன் இஸ் திஸ் சிஸ்டம் டெல் மீ. No, it's true. I mean, this is what we are doing. This is so bad. I mean, literally, I'm telling you, here is a child who knows the answer, but you are failing him because he could not recall it between 9 and 10:30. Adena moortham adhi. Nijam, I mean, one nerthle teyume, illa, one kalyanam mudike mudiyadha, time neram pochi. Enna anyayam padranga paadiga, we are only doing, appa enna anyayam yaaru solradhu? வீட்டுல நமக்கு குழந்தைகள் இருக்குமில்ல, வீட்டுல. So you have got a 2-year-old child, 3-year-old child, ella irukum illa. Suppose you got 2-year-old child in the house, who takes care of the 2-year-old child? Tell me, your 6-year-old child or 8-year-old child pannuvaanga pannamaata? You will encourage also, kutha ko ka paathe, tambik paare solvaangala, they will take care of. But the moment you come to school, no, only this data manufacturer, only all 5-year-old in one place, 6 in one place, sir. This is not how human beings learn. We learn from each other. Apdi thana? You are all of you here, you are 18 years old. I am 20, I am 75 years old. Finally, we are learning, no? All 18 years old, amma solringa. Enna adhu? Enna adhu, sir, sir, apdi thana? Nama rendu per thana kedava. Right. So, my point is, what is the logic? Think about this. What is this logic? Why are we doing? I am not saying don't do. I am saying please give me a logical reason, psychologically speaking, why children in a class must all be of the same age. Why? What is the, is there any logic? You know, simply something has been done, we are continuing to do without applying our own intelligence and thought to it. Similarly, sir, seating to kill or inter-student communication. Now see, seating will be like this. So if people at the back, what are you seeing? The back of somebody's head. How interesting is that? Tell me. Then we say pin drop silence. I had a teacher in my school. He would pull out his belt. He would hold it like this. I will powder you, he will say. Very nice man. He never powdered anybody. But he used to say, silence. No one. No noise. Pin drop silence. How will you learn? How will you teach? Where is the communication? Where is the interaction? You don't want them to talk. You don't want them to ask questions. You don't want them to do anything. And one reason is, I don't know in your place, but one reason in general schools is, we have too many people. If you have got a class with 60 students, 70 students, how can you even encourage any communication? Because nothing will be done. You cannot do anything. Alright. Wait. After 15 years of schooling, 16, 17 years of school, let me ask you a question. Look up, go and look up tomorrow, do this as a homework for yourself. Go and look up the employment in the newspaper or wherever, you know, employment, what do you call this, advertisements, right? Job advertisements. Find me one which says high school graduate. So, after 17 years, totally 17 years ago, from the time they pre-primary, 17 years of full-time education, minimum 8 hours a day, maybe more. Then you add to that traveling time, for which they are paying. We are creating a product which is completely useless for anything in life. No, I'll give you an example. Again, don't do this. But I'm seriously. Once your child comes out of school, graduates, let us say your son or daughter graduates 12th class, first in the entire university, first in the whole country, whatever. So, graduation done very well. Now, you tell this child, you go away from home for 1 month. Do not come back home. Don't go to your auntie's place or grandmother's place. No, you take care of yourself. Four months after that, goodbye. உண்மையாக அந்த பொண்ணு அந்த பையன் உயிரோட இருப்பாரா இல்லையான்னு கூட நமக்கு வந்து சொல்ல முடியாது. He will get kidnapped, he will get trafficked, he will be killed somewhere or something will happen to him. He has no means of earning a living because we never taught him how to earn a living. He has no understanding of how life and society is. He cannot take care of himself. He does not know how to manage money. He does not have any life skills, even though he has qualified very highly in the examination. This is correct or not correct? It is happening everywhere. Everywhere it is happening. Right? So seriously, my point is, we have to rethink the way we are teaching. What is it we are for? I am not saying don't teach math, don't teach science. Please teach everything. What is good stuff? It is not useless. We need to teach all this. But we need to teach this in a different way. Where you are also teaching ethics and morals, where you are also teaching life skills, where you are also teaching responsibility, you are also teaching citizenship, you are also teaching interpersonal communication, you are teaching conflict resolution, conflict management. And the subjects also which you are teaching them in a way of how they relate to each other. Not discrete subjects, either on the physics in Chennai, this will be sitting in one box here, this chemistry is another box, in the box, on the box, or connection, and the mari. We should not teach in this way at all. That is my point. Right? Now, all right, I think collect dots or connect dots. Today what we do in the name of education is collecting dots. We need to connect the dots. I'm not saying don't, you have to collect the dots to connect them. But if you just collect and leave it, it's a waste of time. That is the difference. education, my mind, consists of doing these four things. Number one is awakening the conscience. Teach what is right and what is wrong. Teach what is honest and what is dishonest. Teach what is correct and what is not correct. Not because of fear of punishment. No. What is right is right and what is wrong even if there is no price to pay. What is wrong even if you get away with it, it's still wrong. And that is what we need to teach. Awaken the conscience. Second one is create an excitement for learning. They should like to learn. They should want to learn. They should come to the school with this thirst of knowledge. Number three is make sense in terms of application. This is what I learned. Now so what? You teach them the principle of leverage. Now what? How do I use this principle of leverage in life? You're teaching them about sound waves. Now what? How do we apply this? Application. Because knowledge without application makes no sense. That is why they have to also mug up the stuff. What else will you do? It doesn't make any sense. I have to still regurgitate that in examination. So therefore, I have to mug it up. And last one is social skills basket. Communication, conflict resolution, respecting each other, valuing each other, respecting difference. I am from one religion, somebody else is from another religion. What must I do? Fight with them. No, respect them. Seriously. Respect them. I don't believe what they believe. No problem. We respect them. We should value them. Somebody is not like me, somebody has got a problem, what must I do? Take a video and post on Facebook. Huh? Seriously, I'm saying, how did this happen? This is happening everywhere, no? What must I do? Go help the person. Don't take videos. Get involved in that thing. Something wrong is happening. Stop that something wrong. Don't stand there taking a video. This is what we need to teach. Social skills basket. And what I'm saying is not the sum total, at least some pointers, right? I will leave you to think about others. Basic foundation of values. Because values drive behavior and behavior drives results. So in the end, if we want our children to win, if we want them to be successful, they must do the right things. And they will do the right things only if they have the right values. Not otherwise. That is what we need to focus on. I think I have kept you here long enough. And so I am going to let you go. I have, this presentation also is there with madam. Please, most welcome. Please take it, use it, see it. And also the videos are there. Please let them see all the videos. My email is there somewhere, I think at the end of this presentation. Most welcome, you can email me. I will be very happy to get email from you. And I will be happy to answer any questions that you have. Thank you very much for inviting me and for sitting so long. I hope I did not take too much of your time. Already we started late. So, thank you so much. And I will see some of you or more of you tomorrow.